And another ball. Back up the middle and a base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center. And the batter will be the shortstop, Eli White. And first offering is fouled off. Davis, the runner at first with two gone. Gets a piece and stays alive. Just misses with that one. Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Obi Milner.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleeding and keep this score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
Naylor at the plate now as he chases after that one.
Number eight. With
swing and a miss. Oh, a two down.
Definitely not a pitch location you're expecting up there as a hitter when you know the guy's got a good sinker ball. If he can get in that location, boy, you've got to look top to bottom, and that's going to make it very difficult to hit.
So the Rockies lineup turns over. Next for Colorado, Key Brian Hayes.
And it may be a long shot, but a triple here will give him the cycle.
Swing and a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Here's Nathaniel Lowe. He's already homered in this game. Swing and a miss, and that one missed by a ton.
Oh, one's the count.
The Rockies up big in this one, and we're in the top of the eighth. Awkward swing there from the big left-handed hitter.
Off balance as well.
Got him swinging. Had him way out front of the slur. So now it's Corey Seager. Checks his swing. Appeal down to third. Did not go. Two outs. That one clubbed out towards left center. That'll be extra bases. Around second is Hayes. Around third, he'll score, and they now lead by nine.
Comes through with the RBI. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Pulled down the line. This one hammered, but it's foul.
Trying to steal the first pitch strike with the breaking ball right there, but he was all over it in the box. Kind of sets up an interesting at bat the rest of the way. A little chess match here.
That misses, and the count even 1-1. The 1-1 is fouled off. Seager stands at second with two gone. Next pitch is downstairs. Man at second. And another ball.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
And he grounds one back up the middle. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. The run comes in from second, and it's 13-3.
Nice at bat right there. Not just the result, but also seeing a lot of pitches. Made him really work out there on the mound. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Makes the catch, inning over. Bottom eight, welcome back as we've got a pinch hitter, number 37. This one lifted in the air, left field. Hernandez makes the catch, and there's one gone. White Sox making a move for a pinch hitter, Bryce Terang. One out, the base is empty for him. Just off the outside edge, ball one. In the air, center field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. Looks like it'll be a pinch hitter. Alekmes Diaz looking for a two-out spark with the bases empty. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. That was blasted to the moon. It's 13-4.
Wasn't fooled on the first pitch at all. He squared it up right away. I love the approach as a pinch hitter right there. Don't let him steal a strike. On you just because you're coming in cold off the bench. If you get something to handle, jump all over it. And he was on that one. That's a big boost to the dugout.
Tosses to first, inning over. So remaining in the game defensively, Bryce Terang. He'll be out center now after pinch hitting. Here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. The pitch. And a foul ball.
Number 36.
Here comes the 0-1. Swings through that.
0-2.
Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. Davis collects, fires to first. Got him. One away on the strikeout. So up next, Matt McClain. Swing and a miss. As he was out front that time. Activity in the pen for the White Sox. Emmanuel Clase, the closer, is getting loose. Now this ball is well hit. This one's got a chance. Tattooed to Tater Town and gone. And they add a run. It's 14-4. Two pitches, two swings, that one for a home run.
Looking to be aggressive all the way, and it paid off for him in a big way. That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
Now it's the DH, Jake Cronenworth. That just misses. 1-0. One out, base is empty, and a run in here at the top of the ninth. Two now. This one smoked on its way out of here. Another one. Back-to-back homers, and they add to their lead. It's 15-4.
Back-to-back homers, always a special feeling at the ballpark, especially if it's your team that does it and those guys get to slap hands at home plate. This is the kind of thing that can really fire up a ball club.
So they turn things over to the righty, Jimmy Garcia.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
And the righty deals. On the ground to the left. That's it out.
The third baseman, number 13, Key Brian Hayes.
So the batting order turns over. Now the third baseman, Key Brian Hayes. He's already homered here in this one. And he swings through that one.
Man, that was pretty gross right there.
Two outs, base is empty. Swings through that one out in front that time.
No ball, two strikes.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Out number three. For the bottom of the ninth, and they'll go with a pinch hitter to get it started. MJ Melendez.
Now, plenty of work to do on offense, so they're just looking for any kind of spark here.
Gausman back to work. That one catches the corner for a strike. Strike two.
Goodness, I think he just took the best pitch he's going to see in this at bat. You don't get many like that in that location. I don't know if you take that pitch against any pitcher out there on the mound.
Line drive, caught.
He put a really good swing on that pitch and hit the ball hard. You know, line drives don't always find a hole, but the more you can hit the ball like that with good exit velo, the better off you're going to be in the long run.
Number one comes on now.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
Low snags it. That's out number two. Rogers checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. Nope, he held back. Two down, nobody on. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. The White Sox down to their final strike. And a 1-2. Ground ball to the right side. And it goes just foul. And a foul ball. He stays alive. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Stays alive. Battling here as he fouls it away. Two down, nobody on. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And he's got it, ball game. And the Rockies take this one in a blowout.
Offensive explosion today for these players. They gave up a few runs, but they had more than enough firepower to turn this one into a blowout.
This one ends 15-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by the Game of the Week. I'm John Schaub. We'll talk to you soon.
El que quiera ser, baby, hoy va a tener que pasar.
hours and